Age-related hearing impairment, or presbycusis, is a prevalent issue in our society and the number one communication problem among the older population.
A multidisciplinary team of researchers conducted a 9-year study through the Global Center for Hearing and Speech Research and has now pinpointed the gene linked to hearing and speech processing. Robert Frisina, one of the lead researchers at the University of South Florida, explains the discovery.
So that's where the breakthrough came. After that hard work, we have found a gene that we have good evidence is involved in age-related hearing loss. And that's the first time in our field that anyone's identified and really nailed down the function of a gene.
The study has shown that the function of that gene, GRM7, changes over time for different reasons affecting the quality of the sound conversion process.
Every cell in your body has all your genes. And the gene's main job is to make proteins. And the proteins are what makes all of our cells work. If you have a change in one of your genes, it can cause a problem with the function of the protein. What we've identified here is a gene that makes a protein for the inner ear, where the cells in the inner ear convert sound into the code of the nervous system so that you can hear. As you get older, you not only lose sensitivity to sound, but your brain gets older too, and it can't sort out all the different sounds as well as when you're young. And this particular gene, we really saw relations between how sensitive you are to hearing and the different variations of the gene.
The research included a comprehensive range of hearing tests and a compilation of DNA and family medical history information.
So we not only used tones when we assessed the hearing of the participants in this study, but we also used speech sounds. So we got some relations between the speech processing and the different variations of this gene that we identified.
The study focused on the natural aging process without other possible causes of hearing loss.
So genes and environment interact. Hormones would be an example of what we call environment in this case. So we tried to take those environmental factors out so that we were just left with the genes and the age-related hearing loss, and we were able to compare those.
The team discovered GRM7 after a limited study in Europe uncovered a broader group of genes that could possibly be related to hearing loss.
It's kind of a two-step process now to really get a breakthrough in human genetics. You need some clues because you have 40,000 genes roughly. Where do you look? So we had a clue from this other study that this might be a gene involved in age-related hearing loss. And then we took that second breakthrough step where we really nailed it down with comprehensive hearing tests and much more sophisticated mathematical and biostatistical analyses and genetic analyses to really present enough evidence that, yeah, this is the first gene involved in age-related hearing loss.
The discovery has real implications for early treatment options to prevent age-related hearing loss.
There are many lines of research, not just in hearing, but in all neural systems, sensory systems, where if we know the problem, we know that the protein is being made a little bit incorrectly. There are ways right on the horizon now in the next decade where we're going to be able to compensate or correct for that protein.